We're Liz and Dennis, full-time RVers who for the past 8 months have traveled all across Mexico in our Class C RV. After a short break to enjoy the beaches of the Riviera Maya with family last week, we're back in our rig and taking advantage of the perks of van life here in Mexico. Tag along with us this week as we explore Mahahual, our favorite Mexican beach town yet.
Do you like our spot?
Had to get a roadie because you told me you ain't drinking nothing at the beach club.
Maybe we should have like food, like vegetables or breakfast before we just have alcohol?
We're gonna do that too. I mean, no one said we're not gonna do that. Someone did say that I wasn't gonna be able to enjoy a brew.
One of the things I love about RV life, especially taking an RV trip through Mexico, is that we can explore beautiful places in a more intimate way. The last week, over New Year's, we had our family come in town and we explored all of the Riviera Maya, visiting Tulum. We stayed in Puerto Aventura. We went to Playa del Carmen. It was a really good time. It was super touristy and we saw Mexico, I think, in a way a lot of foreigners who are visiting here do. So we needed a little bit of a break. We ended up driving about 3.5 hours away to the town of Mahahual, which is actually a port town for huge cruise ships, which right now from COVID-19, cruise ships aren't operating. So it's a little bit of a ghost town, but it's just as beautiful of beaches, just as gorgeous waters. You can snorkel, there's great food. And the best part about it all is we're camping here for free. We're literally in front of the beach. We can go snorkel whenever we want to, and we can explore the town through the Malecon, which right now we're kind of hungry. And since the sun has come out after raining for like a full day, we're ready to explore. Join us.
Malecon is basically a giant foot and bike path that will take you all along the shoreline in the town. All along the Malecon, there's tons of restaurants and beach clubs and public access beaches with cabanas and of course tourist shops, so you can get all your tchotchke stuff when you get off the cruise ship. But yeah, it's a pretty rad little town. I'm glad that it's sleepy right now, because we literally, feels like we have the whole place to ourselves. It's not necessarily, I wouldn't say ghost town like Liz said earlier, but it's definitely way quieter than it normally would be, that's for sure.
But before we can enjoy the beach and the beautiful water here, I need to get some food because I am starving. So we ended up finding a cute little restaurant called Tierra Verde. It's like an organic, vegan, raw shop. And after a lot of street food in the past week and kind of overindulging with our family on vacation, we could use a little bit of healthy food. So we're gonna get some greens in our body, some vegetables, and then we can relax and enjoy. So good. Plantain tacos are super tasty. And the views here, they just can't be beat. And now, time for the beach. Water is gorgeous today. It's so amazing how crystal clear the water is here. beautiful day. Saw so many different types of fish while we were down there. Supposedly, if you go even past the first reef, past the break, that there's even more wildlife, including sea turtles. Hopefully tomorrow we're going to go to another area where some sea turtles hang out. It's been a pretty relaxing, awesome day so far, though, I'm not going to lie.
And we're finishing the night off walking the Malecon. It goes for miles, so this is definitely a good way to see the city. A lot of people have rented bikes, and they're definitely making that their mode of transportation. But it's a really great way to walk, take a morning jog. Not that we jog. The problem with having a relaxing day at the beach and starting your day off with a delicious lunch out is that you don't want to cook. So we ended up passing a cute little pizza shop that's right below the place we came for lunch, Tierra Verde. So we're grabbing a pizza to go and we're gonna enjoy a little bit of movie night in the RV. We also have another problem where we're out of propane and our solar panels aren't exactly working. So we have no way to recharge our batteries without running our generator, but we're out of propane to run our generator. There's no propane fill-up stations in Mahahual. They just have trucks that come through on random days. So fingers crossed we'll find a truck tomorrow. Because if not, we're in quite a pickle. But for now, we can't solve the problem. So we're just going to enjoy pizza. So we're gonna hop on the scooter now. We're going to scout through town to try and find a gas delivery truck at one of the restaurants or hotels here and hopefully get them to come fill up ours. But it's also a good way to explore the town. We found someone! Right as we were about to go home and just kind of call it bust, we found a gas company. So happy we ended up finding the gas company. Which, by the way, if you're new around here, you might not know that we have our own RV guide to Mexico. So if you're wondering how we find free camping spots like this epic one we're at today, or how we navigate finding water, dumping our tanks, filling propane and gas, we have a guide that explains all of that and so much more. We're really proud of the guide. We worked super hard on it and we made it so that you can create your own path, that you don't just have to follow in our own footsteps, but that you have the tools to successfully RV or navigate a trip. One of our patrons actually bought the RV guide and ended up taking an epic motorcycle trip all of Baja California. And he wrote us a really awesome comment to let us know how much the guide helped him and prepare, tell him what paperwork he needed, things like that. So it's definitely going to set you up for success if you're interested. We'll have a link to that down below. But I think we're just going to continue working around the RV for a few more hours so that we can go enjoy more of the beautiful sunshine and reefs and gorgeous beaches here in Mahahual. Your landscape constantly changes as RVers. Being able to be in new places and explore new things and meet new people and be in the comfort of our own home is our choice. That's how we decided to live our life. And you can too. So if you've been considering RVing, van life, honestly, there's never gonna be a perfect time, but if there were, it would probably be now. With everyone working remotely, with the opportunity to travel safely, if you're not happy, make a change. It's a new year. New possibilities. I'm just loving our spot. The first night it was really loud here. We were really worried it was going to be like that every night, but I think it was an anomaly. It's been super quiet here throughout. But if you are looking for a little bit more of a secure spot than just right here out in the open next to the lighthouse, there is paid RV camping down the beach, past where the Malecon ends for walking or pedestrians. I believe it's like 80 to 150 pesos depending on the time of year, how busy they are. But for us, this spot has been perfect. We love that whenever we're done working for the day, we can just go straight out into the water and snorkel or just chat with friends. We ended up meeting a lovely couple from Uruguay, and they're traveling in their car tent camping throughout all of Mexico. So we're gonna pop open some coconuts with them. And today's goal is to try and snorkel with sea turtles. There's a spot just around off the Malecon that I guess the sea turtles like to hang out in. We've never seen them in the wild like this, so it would be a big win for us. Dennis has seen a ton of cool stuff yesterday. He saw an eel while he was snorkeling, lionfish, stingrays, manta rays. I saw a barracuda. So there's definitely a lot of diversity here in these reefs, so this would just be like the icing on the cake. And if you are an experienced diver, this is definitely a great place for you to do some deep dives. There's tons of dive shops in and around this area that offer just like night swims, or you can do a few day trips out. Sea turtles.
Muy bien.
Look at this fancy
reusable
frissons. You don't get none because you didn't offer me any at the Airbnb.
I did offer you some. You were just in your own world.
Mm. Oh. That was really good.
It's our last day here in Mahahual, and we decided to treat ourselves to a nice little breakfast out with our new friends. We ended up finding a tacos de canasta restaurant that was on the Malecon yesterday, and got some canasta tacos. They were delicious. If you don't know what tacos de canasta are, we'll have a link to when we first tried them back in Puebla. But if you're looking for breakfast here, we definitely suggest going off the beaten path and seeking out some smaller, less maybe touristy spots, especially here in Mahahual. Everything on the Malecon is really beautiful restaurants with more typical American style eggs, pancakes. You can kind of get whatever you want that you might be familiar with. But in Mexico, they like to have savory breakfasts, things like tacos, tortas, gorditas.
Just walk a block off of the Malecon into the center of town, basically away from the beach, and you'll find all of the little local spots, like, you know, some lady selling cochinita pibil tortas in front of an abarrotes tienda, or, you know, some
for 30 local pesos.
Yeah.
So that's what we're gonna start our day off with, and then we're gonna finish with some tacos de canasta. But it's definitely a more authentic experience for when you're visiting a place, and we highly recommend seeking out those small little unique places.
Muchas gracias.
Dude, this bread is so fresh and so like soft and crispy the way she grilled it. And the cochinita was very good. I'm excited.
¿Qué piensas?
Muy bueno.
Está bueno.
Mm. For those watching that know that I'm mostly vegetarian, yes, I'm breaking the rules. But when Coach Anita's around, you break the rules.
That's worth it. Look at this guy. He doesn't like, no, you don't
know what this is. We are so thankful we took a little detour to come to this beautiful town. And hopefully if you're coming in the future, you get to experience this gorgeous little slice of heaven here in Quintana Roo. But please remember that right now, our experience is much more tranquilo than probably when you'll be visiting. If cruise ships are traveling here and here during your stay, expect hundreds to potentially thousands more people. They have as many as 5 cruise ships docked here at once. So when those flood of people come into town, it can be a completely different experience than what we showed you here, but it's still worth coming to and experiencing. We're really thankful that we got to meet Juan and Flora. It kind of made it extra special. It's always nice to have friends to experience a place with. I feel like sometimes the friendships that you make at that place kind of enhance your experience there. And we got along so well, they're coming with us to Bacalar. So you'll be able to see more of them and more of our fun adventures in next week's video. We'll see you next Monday. Oh my gosh, this is so much fun. It's our second farmacia that we've passed since being in the Riviera Maya, and it is very clear who their demographic is from their marketing. Oh boy. I'm gonna get amoxicillin over the counter here. A Z-pad? Like, oh my god. Like vibrates the whole RV.
I know. You feel it on the floor. Uh-huh. It's crazy.